on that bridge. We weren't out to cause trouble, we were just messing about. We found a metal cable lying around. Our plan was to catch a train. I grabbed onto the cable, my cousin grabbed onto the other cable, and I said, on the count of three, I'll throw it over. One, two, and we threw it. All I knew is that the bottom was electric, nothing about the overhead cables. I went into shock and then into a seizure. The day was going to my nan's and then was going to have a game. It was unbearable. The worst pain you can imagine. Burnt skin, burnt clothes.
Messing about.
I weren't afraid of nothing because you're always going to be really confused. There's a tightening in all your muscles.
Ringing in my ears. I'm afraid of pain.
As I come around, you know, the scream was getting louder and I realised why it was my cousin. Electric went through his body and out of his stomach.
Our modern way of life uses energy, mostly from burning gas, oil and coal, emitting CO2 into the atmosphere, changing the planet's climate. We also waste energy, which increases CO2 emissions, affecting the climate even further. We are now producing more CO2 than the world can cope with. We need to tackle climate change now, by reducing the CO2 emissions we're each responsible for. To find out more about climate change and how to reduce your CO2 footprint, go to direct.gov.uk/act-on-CO2.
I was so safe and happy when I was 7. I lived with my mum, my dad, and my big brothers in a tall house. I went to school, I played with my friends, and a teddy called Fred. I had my own little room which I never kept tidy. That's why I was sleeping when the house caught fire. There was no sound from the smoke alarm. It wasn't Daddy's fault, we just wanted a battery for my new Christmas present.
Hi, I'm Tom. These are my mates. They're off to Danny's tonight, but I'm not going. My mum and dad. They've been arguing a lot lately.
Alright, Dave. How's the bike?
Hey, that's Debbie. She's meant to be going out with me, but she's with Tarek. Again.
Debbie!
That's the second time that's happened this week. Hurt a lot more the first time.
My hobbies are football, cycling. I like playing in the street. And I like going down to the park and stuff. I like collecting medals, like football medals. I like the way they're presented and stuff because some are shiny and some are like blue, silver, green, stuff like that. But they're always, the ones that I pick are always like blue, but with shiny bits. And I always make sure that if I have a football player, it ain't just one with a leg out, it's one with an actual football on it.
Thank you. a squeezing across the chest, a feeling of unease. The early symptoms of a heart attack don't always feel severe, but it's never too early to call 999 and describe your symptoms.
Every hour of every day, somebody in Scotland has a house fire. Is your home as safe as you think it is?
Carbon monoxide from faulty gas appliances can kill. By law, landlords must have all appliances they provide safety checked by Corby registered installers. Ask for proof now, or tonight it could be you.
Smoke from a fire will leave you for dead. Test your smoke alarms this clock change weekend. Tick-tock test before it's too late.
Not scared of the dark. Not scared of spiders. I'm not scared of clowns. I'm not scared of Becky Taylor. I'm scared of my mum smoking.
No.
I'm scared that my mum will die.
For help quitting, call 0800 884411 or press red.
The boy who didn't stop, look, and listen. Before his leg was bent backwards, he loved to play football all day. But the boy didn't cross in a safe place where he could see cars come his way. He then didn't stop, look, and listen. A car hit him at quite a pace. And now he cannot play football because his leg broke in more than one place. The girl who didn't dress bright in the dark. She always liked to look her best, so didn't wear a nice bright vest or any clothing that was bright when she was out at nearly night. But traffic couldn't see her, see. And now she isn't so trendy. A car drove right into her guts and covered her with bruisy cuts. The boy who didn't look for a safe place to cross. He couldn't be bothered to walk to a place where cars could be seen from a nice open space. So he crossed the road right next to a bend. Now his arm for some while would be struggling to mend. A car cannot dodge what it cannot see, so flatten the boy. Unfortunately, now he can't swim, dress himself, or go-kart. Because his arm is all limp and falling apart. Always cross where you can see what's coming.
Last year in England, 15 children died in house fires. Children like yours. So parents, I'd like you to make a promise. Repeat after me. I swear on my child's life to test my smoke alarm on clock change day. Give my family the best chance of surviving a house fire. You did promise, didn't you? Because you can't turn back time.
Over 80% of cigarette smoke is invisible, so no matter how careful you are, they still breathe in the harmful poisons. If you could see what's really there, you wouldn't smoke. Text INVISIBLE to 63818 for a smoke-free kit. Over 80% of cigarette smoke is invisible, so no matter how careful you are, they still breathe in the harmful poisons. If you could see what's really there, you wouldn't smoke. Text INVISIBLE to 63818 for a smoke-free kit.
Kids breathe faster than adults. When you smoke indoors, your secondhand smoke lingers in the air. You can't see it or smell it, but it's there. No matter what you do, the harmful chemicals move from room to room for up to 5 hours. And because your child breathes faster than you, they'll breathe more of those harmful chemicals. You can choose whether your child breathes secondhand smoke or clean air. For your kid's sake, don't smoke indoors. Take it right outside.
Richard didn't want to die, but he couldn't stop himself. The collision with the car didn't kill him, but he wasn't wearing a seatbelt, so he continued on his journey. When he hit the inside of the car, that didn't kill him either. But his internal organs carried on travelling until they hit his ribcage, and his lungs were punctured, and the main artery from his heart was torn. And that's what killed Richard.
Tonight, John will die in his sleep. He's warm, comfortable, and has his family by his side. Drive tired.
Thank you, Mummy.
Oh, darling.
Thank you, Mummy. Thank you, Mummy. Thank you, Mummy.
Leave it there, lovely.
Thank you, Mummy.
Oh.
The smoke and fumes from a house fire can kill a child in under a minute. Wake up. Get a smoke alarm.
You might know a bit about coronary heart disease. You might know that it affects people of different ages and ethnicities, and that it's one of the UK's biggest killers. But you might not know that every year, over 23,000 of its victims
are women. Heart disease is her disease.
Four, five, six.
Wait, no.
Oh, my back.
Oh, your back. Oh, is it okay?
Why don't you go and push your sister in the swings?
All right, then. It's so boring, you know.
You two are becoming a couple of cheeky monkeys.
You're becoming a cheeky monkey!
When you smoke, toxins attack your insides, causing your body to rot. If you could see the rot, you'd stop. Search Smoke Free for free quitting support.
On the 3rd of March last year, the Powell family were woken by their smoke alarm. Mrs. Powell escaped with the baby. Her husband went to get their little girls. Finding their beds empty, he fought his way outside. The girls weren't there. He tried to return but was beaten back by flames. I found their bodies in the wardrobe, where they'd hidden.
Would you know what to do in a fire? Make your plan. Get out alive.
You know that feeling when you wake up in a basement with a massive gaping hole in your chest? No? Well, I've had better mornings.
Pablo.
Turns out I've been used to smuggle cocaine into the country, which does rather prompt the question, what's the big deal with coke? So I talked to this dealer and he said,
it's all about the profit.
And making sure no one messes with us!
Okay, Mr. Gunn, sir. And these headache pills he's cutting his coke with couldn't wait to tell me that...
Actually, on the street, it's only 30% cocaine.
And 70%, who the hell knows?
That I met Mr. Disco here.
Lots of people are doing it, Pablo!
Really? So I went to this nasty toilet and this girl asked me...
Could you spare us a tenner?
No, I'm a dog, obviously. Oh, by the way, your heart's beating so fast you can't get a word out. And a coked-up friend is no help at all.
Get out of my face! Leave me alone!
Steady on. And look who we have here. A bleeding nostril. Perfect.
I'm bleeding!
Well done. Yes, you are. So I picked up the phone, somehow, and talked to Frank. Finally, someone who made sense.
There's a darker side to coke. To find out more, visit talktofrank.com.
So, how long can you hold your breath? Ready? Land, you would have survived this, as the average person can hold their breath for 45 seconds. In the water, you might not last 10. Even on a warm day, cold water shock can leave you helpless. British and Irish waters are dangerously unpredictable. Over 200 people accidentally die each year.
If you hit me at 40 miles an hour, there's around an 80% chance I'll die. Hit me at 30 and there's around an 80% chance I'll live.
Oh.
Sarah? Are you asleep? Sarah? Hi.
Every month, we need to raise £7 million from fundraising and monthly donations. However you choose to give, together, we will make child abuse stop. Full stop.
Ecstasy.
You don't know if you'll be the one who'll have an extreme reaction. Leading to fits. Kidney failure. And even death. If you take speed, you could get more than you expected, like mental illness, your heart packing in, or a blood vessel busting in your head. Troubles with acid is you never know when it's going to turn into a bad trip.
Fine. Brilliant. All right, I'll see you on the 9th. Okay, bye.
The average smoker needs over 5,000 cigarettes a year. Get unhooked. Call 0800 169 0169 or visit getunhooked.co.uk.
Ten more minutes in homework, yeah?
The average smoker needs over 5,000 cigarettes a year. Get unhooked. Call 0800 169 0169 or visit getunhooked.co.uk. If you're a smoker, getting unhooked isn't easy. That's why the NHS offers a whole range of ways to help you stop. To find out what's best for you, call 0800 169 0169, press the red button, or visit getunhooked.co.uk. If you're a smoker, getting unhooked isn't easy. That's why the NHS offers a whole range of ways to help you stop. To find out what's best for you, call 0800 169 0169, press the red button, or visit getunhooked.co.uk.
I am the fire that leaves you homeless. A heart attack in aisle 6. The prescription you cannot collect. I am the boiled sweet stuck in your child's throat. The motorway pileup that leaves you traumatized. The food shopping you cannot do. I'm the reason you need a wheelchair. The flood that leaves you stranded. The empty house when you return from hospital. I am a crisis. And I don't care who you are.
Over, Sliz.
Nah, I'm not really into smack.
How do you know until you've tried?
Come on, have a go for me. We're only having a chase.
No, just don't really.
Boring, boring.
Oh, come on, that's a good laugh.
I just don't really.
We are junkies or something. Look, no trying to do it once every now and then.
Yeah, I know that. I just.
You're not scared, are you, Liz?
No, of course I'm not.
Boring.
Past her bedtime.
Man, it's only a smoke.
Yeah. You are
key. Yeah. Trust me.
First smoke of heroin can make you throw up, but some people still go back for more. If you get into it, your looks will start to go, and you'll feel even worse. If you depend on it, chances are you'll end up sharing a needle. And if it's infected with AIDS, where does that leave you?
A fire doesn't have to kill you to take your life.
Will everyone please take their seats? Very shortly, your row will be divided into units of 3. Do not obstruct the gangways whilst the cages are installed. There is no cause for alarm. These cages are for your protection. Please cooperate with the surgeons. They will remove your teeth and nails. This greatly reduces the incidence of cannibalism. It is in your interest to comply. Eating, sleeping, and defecating may cause some discomfort, but your space allowance complies exactly with government regulations, and you have the satisfaction of knowing that you are part of one of the world's most cost-effective production systems. You have nothing to worry about. This system has been tested on 45 million specimens, with, I might add, your approval. Welcome to the battery.
This is Michael. Today he's going to hit his girlfriend so hard she ends up with permanent brain damage.
Three dead in this fickle. careless critical. They say the guy without the seatbelt did the damage.
No seatbelt, no excuse. From DOE, supported by AXA Insurance.
This blizzard's come down really fast. The road's blocked. We won't be going anywhere tonight. We've got a blanket, but it's only big enough for one.
University about a year ago. Now we're escorting these civilian convoys. These civil wars have been over that long, so these aid convoys need to be set.
Five field!
Yes, Yammer.
Zero, this is Mike 2-0. Contact, waste
time. Stay the truck!
Stay in the truck!
Right, we got to get to them.
Surveyor came round on Saturday, so I hope the something will start moving.
Fingers crossed.
Start time 09:15 hours. Gunshot wound to right side of chest, 0.9 centimetres diameter. Photograph of that, please.
Services are so expensive. My cousin had subsidence. Cost her a fortune.
Bruising to right wrist, consistent with witness reports that deceased firearm was turned against him. Projectile has passed through underlying pectoralis muscle before shattering right fifth rib.
Right lung, 420 grams.
Come on.
We're going swimming, my brother and I. We're going swimming with our best friend. We're going to swim in the canal, even though it's very cold and dirty. My brother and I run down the towpath.
We're happy to be running because we don't get taken out as often as we used to.
Come on.
Best friend seems to have less time these days.
Come here.
Never been down this way before.
Come here.
Usually we go where there's more people.
Good.
Now we're stopping. Suddenly my brother and I don't feel like swimming anymore. It's very cold. Very cold. So cold, our best friend puts us in a sack to keep us warm. I hope he doesn't slip, because it'd be very difficult to swim in this small sack.
How about we two?
What, heroin?
Aye, smack. You're only smoking it.
Superb, your pride and joy, is it? 20 quid.
Yes!
Where are you off to?
Just off to the sports centre.
What do you think you're doing?
I wasn't stealing!
That's exactly what you're doing. Stuart, where are you going?
Any spare change, pal?
Your car is designed to crumple on impact. Your face isn't.
They've let you out again, have they? You worthless little cow!
Come on in.
Read.
Check the fridge.
I don't know what it says, all right?
You okay? Here, 20 quid.
Mom, give me the money! Mom!
You worthless little cow.
I am the spirit of dark and lonely water, ready to trap the unwary, the show-off, the fool. And this is the kind of place you'd expect to find me. But no one expects to find me here. It seems too ordinary. But that pool is deep. The boy is showing off. The bank is slippery. The show-offs are easy. But the unwary ones are easier still. This branch is weak, rotten. It'll never take his way. Only a fool would ignore this. But there's one born every minute. Under the water there are traps, old cars, bedsteads, weeds, hidden depths. It's the perfect place for an accident.
Quick, give us that big stick to get him out.
Sensible children I have no power over them.
Oi, mate, that's a stupid place to swim. Hey, go over and get that thing to wrap him in. You don't have to feel cold, mate. How long was you in there?
Ew, awful thing.
I'll be back, back, back.
First hit me on our anniversary. I told myself he'd change when I had Millie, but it's bad as ever. When he hits me hard. Millie doesn't know. I hope she doesn't know.
There is now a danger that has become a threat to us all. It is a deadly disease and there is no known cure. The virus can be passed during sexual intercourse with an infected person. Anyone can get it, man or woman. So far, it's been confined to small groups, but it's spreading. So protect yourself and read this leaflet when it arrives. If you ignore AIDS, it could be the death of you. So don't die of ignorance.
If your chip pan catches fire, don't panic. Just follow these instructions. 1. Turn off the heat. 2. Run a cloth under a tap and wring it out. 3. Cover the pan and then wait until it's cooled right down. Don't try and move the pan. And whatever you do, don't throw water over the fire. The effects can be devastating.
Thank you. ready for you now.
Well, Michael, the results of your blood tests have come through, and we have found antibodies that indicate that you are HIV positive, 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 positive.
The AIDS virus can live on dirty needles and equipment, so don't share. Because just one fix with an infected needle will really get you out of it.
As I went down to the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, come on down, don't you want to go down? Oh, brothers, let's go down, down in the valley to pray. As I went down to the valley to pray, studying about that good old way, and who shall wear the robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way.
When a stroke strikes, it spreads like a fire in the brain. The longer it goes undetected, the more damage is done. To spot the signs of a stroke, you have to think and act fast. F, face. Has their face fallen on one side? Can they smile? A, arms. Can they raise both arms and keep them there? S, speech. Is their speech slurred? T, time. Just like a fire, it's time to call 999 if you see any single one of these signs. The faster you act, the more of the person you save. When stroke strikes, act fast.
Hold on. Better get this, buddy. Hello, Martin.
Wasn't expecting to hear from you today. Well, wasn't Steve supposed to be sorting that out on Friday?
Okay, right. It's not a problem.
Alice is one of thousands of St John Ambulance volunteers. She's fully trained in first aid and knows what to do in any situation.
Say something, buddy.
She can be the difference between life and death. But what she can't do is be there every time.
briefly. Help! Help! Somebody.
On the 12th day of Christmas, a drink driver gave to me 12 months in traction, 11 weeks on crutches, 10 operations, 9 years of nightmares, 8 open flesh with 7 spinal fractures, 6 days unconscious, lungs, and a lifetime in a wheelchair.
When I was very little, a stranger took me away from Mummy. He kept me at a house he pretended to live in. A lady asked where Mummy was. He lied and said she was out. But she still wanted me even though I had no papers. She thought I was cute. She didn't know I was sick. I'm from a puppy farm and in a week I'll be dead.
If you've got a smoke alarm, it's essential that you carry out the following simple checks. Test the battery every week by pressing this button. Then once a year, replace the battery and remove dust from the sensor with a vacuum cleaner. Look after your smoke alarm. If it doesn't wake you, maybe nothing will. Wake up. Check your smoke alarm.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile and maybe tomorrow, you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Gladness, hide every trace of sadness. Although
every year thousands of other animals suffer this ugly pain in the name of beauty, please don't use cosmetics tested in this way.
Lovely. It's been a bit difficult.
I just wish you'd talk to me.
I know it's been hard on you both. But we can talk about that.
I love you.
You too.
Have you played this one?
Yeah, of course I played this.
Right, it's just because it doesn't massively look like United,
though. Hey, Lee, come, cuz. Right, let me just play my game, man.
Where's his pace? He ain't got any pace.
Cross it.
Is there something wrong with your thumbs?
Mate, you are a dirty player, man.
Checkers.
Shut up, bruv.
Oh, he's done him. He's done him again. Oh, title football. I'm just tired all the time.
You're doing really well, Lee.
Thanks. Oh, you're having a mare here, mate.
Shut up, bruv. Oh, you're lucky, Lee. You're lucky.
You look beautiful. You okay?
Yeah.
Are you? Yeah.
We've had the test results, and I'm sorry to say it is cancer. And what we're going to do is run some more tests and talk about your treatment options.
I've got my sister's wedding coming up.
Don't worry, you're going to look great.
So Betty O'Barley and Harry O'Hay wed one another the very next day. And everyone, even the snail who was late, said, "Don't they look happy? Don't they look great?" This they agreed as they sprinkled confetti on Harry O'Hay and his beautiful Betty. Is the best wedding ever. The best wedding yet. The wedding that no one will
ever forget.
Oh, what a
lovely story.
And how did it go with Molly?
I think she understands.
I know it's hard.
Gonna tell me what's up with you?
She's always getting at me. Why are you not advising? Who are them boys you're hanging about with? I can't do anything right. I hate her.
Oi, she's your mum.
I'm sorry, but she just doesn't get it.
Know what? I think she'd have said the same thing about me, you know?
We've had your test results, and I'm afraid it is cancer.
What can he do? He needs me.
I know it's a lot to take in, Brian, but here's what's going to happen next.
Thanks, Grandad.
No bother, pal.
Thank you.
Replica guns are being converted into real guns. They are toys that kill. Visit mothersagainstguns.net and help us get a total ban of replica guns.
I'm in here. Can anybody see me? Can anybody hear? I'm in here, a prisoner of history.
I think he's choking.
You need to try and calm down.
Okay, okay, can you just think?
I don't know if just come on.
I don't know what to do.
How long are they going to be?
They'll be here in 5 minutes.
I don't know.
I'm going to go and get some messages and I'll leave her with Auntie Karen.
All right. Hiya, Cheeky. Hi.
Right, you be safe. And don't be home late.
I won't.
Here is our best pal, Ian.
See if he tries any shit, mate. Don't stall for that, mate.
You need to tell. I think you're scared of him.
Hey, you should be all the man scared.
I know. Hey, nearly got you. Great, man.
You going, son?
Alright.
Alright, troops.
Aight, that's something coming.
Where are
you off to? Not much.
Who's off to tonight? I'll figure it out, bro.
We'll park.
That's alright. Listen, your mum worries about you. Send her a wee text tonight, would you?
Aye.
And stay out of trouble. You hear me?
Aye.
Right, beat it. Go in my garage. See you later.
Wait, that's Abby. You're going to kiss my pal. Abby!
Abby, that's
my pal. He's a swagger.
Abby!
Hey, Elja, what are you doing?
Do I know? You can't get out of my pot. I swear to God.
Stop!
What have you done?
can tell me, hands up, 9 times 8. Sally, do you know the answer?
Shush.
Do you want to come by my house after school?
Nah.
Sally, you're not eating again. What's wrong?
I'm fine. Can I go now?
Fires started by cigarettes kill more than any other. Put it out. Right out.
Rachel, you got me again. Another girl's night, innit?
Nurses make a difference. For information on nursing or returning to nursing with improved pay and conditions, call 0845 6060 655.
I'll relive that day for the rest of my life. Coming home from school, just like any other wet Monday. Apart from what I found, you, motionless, your eyes staring blankly at mine, as if you were cross, not dead. The gun, it looked unreal, like a toy. Dad, I still don't understand why you did it. Why did you leave me all alone?
I was so excited, desperate to find out what was under the tree. I went into your room to find you, but you weren't there. So I rushed downstairs, ready to rip open my presents. I shouted, "Mum! Mum!" And I found you, in the bathroom. And now, that's all I'll ever remember about Christmas.
My dad couldn't stop sobbing. Then the policewoman came in to talk to me. She talked, but I couldn't hear her. Everything shut down after those first words. "We're very sorry. Your mum's died." Not even a note. My world fell apart right there. And I've never really been able to put it back together.
The little girl, she said to me, what are these things that I can see? Each night when I come home from school, when Mama calls me in for tea. Oh, every night a baby dies, and every night her mama cries. What makes those men do what they do to make that person black and blue? Grandpa says they're happy now. They sit with God in paradise with angels' wings, and still somehow it makes me feel like ice. Tell me there's a heaven. Tell me that it's true. Tell me there's a reason why I'm seeing what I do. Tell me there's a heaven where all those people go. Tell me they're all happy now. Papa, tell me that it's so.
Takes a beating. Fight back. Quit now.
Somewhere in this vast place, there's a small group of islands known as the Faroe Islands. No one knows why, but once a year, large groups of pilot whales return here. The islanders look forward to their visit each year and prepare a special homecoming for them. First of all, they herd the whales into the harbor. Then they harpoon them. And then cut them up with hunting knives while they're still alive. The noise you can hear is the whale screaming as it experiences this horrific death. The more the whales scream, the more the crowd seem to enjoy it. Meat is then distributed to the crowd, and once their freezers are crammed full, the rest is left on the beach to rot.
Baggage, madam?
The outcome of a sentimental impulse could mean a sentence of death for the animal you love and couldn't leave behind, and for you or someone like you, death in a manner that is beyond description. Whichever way you look at it, rabies means death.
When your smoke alarm goes off, make sure you know what to do. Plan your escape now, or you might live to regret it.
What's this? Have you had all day, have you? Hey, you've been sitting all day watching telly? Now what the hell are you up to? Look at the state of this place! Look at the state of it! Look at it! What did I tell you about running indoors? All right? What did I tell you? Here you are. What are you up to? I just asked you what you're up to! Don't do this! You dirty bastard! Get out! Get out! Get out! You f***ing run! Get out of here!
So, to get your whole...
Action Man Battlefield Casualties. For PTSD Action Man, danger lurks at every turn.
Who's that?
He never feels safe, not even in his own home. Do what you can to block out the memories.
Look, look, look!
With no support from HQ, it's up to you to find a way.
Looks like we're on our own.
PTSD Action Man now comes with 1,000 Yard Stare Action. With time running out, only you can stop the pain.
Let's get out of here!
Action Man! Action Man! Here comes paralyzed Action Man. Legs really don't work. His spine shattered by an enemy IED. Action Man is crippled by constant pain. Ah! With his bowels out of action, only a colostomy bag can save him from disaster.
Reloading!
But despite his injuries, there can be no rest.
That's work for me!
New cereal with a golden taste.
Action Man! Make the ultimate sacrifice with new dead Action Man. Blown to bits by bombs, it's up to you to pick up the pieces.
We lost him!
Identify the body with dog tags.
Private Smith, 19 years old.
Reward him for valiant effort.
You've been promoted.
Can you dig the grave in time?
Let's do it!
Bury your dead Action Man with full military honors. Present arms, fire! Coffins sold separately. Action Man!
And we'll give you a free what?
Action Man Battlefield Casualties, each sold separately.
Thank you.
birthday to you.
Make a wish.
Granny.
Hello.
Hello.
Have you done your homework?
Adam.
For a general strike.
Ready or not?
Here it comes.
Violent clashes with Britain.
Live ammunition against.
Deserve to get shot.
Have a nice day, Mum.
Air strikes on rebel position.
We are going to stay.
What's happening?
Here we go.
One, two, three, four, five. Is she going to be all right? Five. Look, make her be all right. Calm down.
Four, are you the driver of the vehicle, sir?
No pulse, no response. Patient's been into you.
Have you been drinking, sir?
Charging up.
Just a quick one.
Stand clear.
I thought I'd be okay.
Stand clear. Charging up. Stand clear.
Is she going to be all right?
They're doing the best they can, sir.
Still no pulse. Still no response. Pupil's not reacting. Still nothing. The patient is now asystolic.
I didn't mean it. Oh.
Growing up, just wanted to fit in. There weren't much to do where I lived. On that bridge, we weren't out to cause trouble, we were just messing about. We found a metal cable lying around. Our plan was to catch a train. I grabbed onto the cable, my cousin grabbed onto the other cable, and I said, on the count of three, I'll throw it over. One, two, and we threw it. All I knew is that the bottom was electric, nothing about the overhead cables. I went into shock and then into a seizure. The day was going to my nan's and then was going to have a game. It was unbearable. The worst pain you can imagine. Burnt skin, burnt clothes, messing about. I weren't afraid of nothing, so I was going to be a bit confused. There's a tightening in all your muscles, ringing in my ears. I'm afraid of pain. As I come around, you know, the scream was getting louder and I realised why it was my cousin. Electric went through his body and out of his stomach.
Someone please help me! Help! Someone!
I was 13 years old when I got electrocuted. 25,000 volts went through my body. At the time I was a confident person and now as I grow up it's just knocked me back for six. But that's life and I still have to live with it. I wouldn't wish this upon anyone.
Just 5 miles per hour over the 30 miles per hour speed limit. How much further will it take to stop? 1 foot, 2 feet, 3 feet, 4 feet, 5 feet, 6 feet, 7 feet, 8 feet, 9 feet, 10 feet, 11 feet, 12 feet, 13 feet, 14 feet, 15 feet, 16 feet, 17 feet, 18 feet, 19 feet, 20 feet. Feet. 21 feet.
Elena didn't think anyone would hurt her. Elena trusted everyone.
Maria doesn't trust anyone.
Elena wanted to learn English.
Maria gets beaten if she says no.
Elena worked in a market to support her family.
Maria works for nothing.
Elena wanted to help people and be a nurse.
Maria services up to 40 men a day.
Elena used to cry when her father was cross with her.
Maria doesn't feel anything anymore.
Elena's family thinks she's dead.
Help me.
I was Elena.
I am Maria.
Help me.
I'm here.
Now you know how it feels to get motor neurone disease. Help us fight back.
Thank you.
shut it. But enough. Shut up, I'm going out. I don't want to calm down.
I want to show you what my mum
said. I don't want to hear what your mum said, all right? It is your fault.
It's your fault.
What do you mean the baby? What's so good for me? What's
that? What's that?
What's that? What's that? What's that? What's that? Got a mouth, haven't you? Answer me! The baby! I've heard enough about the baby! Sick of hearing about the baby!
No, wait, please! No, wait!
Shall I tell you about my life? Every time, and I've seen lots of pretty girls. Guess I've got everything I need. I wouldn't ask more, and there's no one I'd rather be.
Could you live with the shame? From DOE.
Matches away from children.
Spots, rotten teeth, depression, anxiety attacks, personality changes, paranoia. Take speed, ecchi or acid and you can develop any of them.
There was no intent. It was never meant to happen. But, yes, I killed somebody. I was driving home in the morning when I thought I was okay, but obviously I wasn't. I've left a husband and children without a mother and a wife, and I've got to live with that for the rest of my life. Very vivid nightmares. More realistic than anything I can actually remember. I'm just very sorry for my victims. The husband and the children and her family.
Loneliness. Emptiness. Painful. Doesn't seem any way out. My younger two children don't understand why I'm in here. They keep saying, apologise and they let you come home. They don't quite realise what I've done. the old lady that I crashed into, she died. And her face comes back every time I sort of close my eyes. I find myself going back in the dream to try and say the things I wanted to say, but it never happens. I sort of wish I could have said something in the hospital. But it's just nothing I could have said, not to make it any better, because nothing would have made it better.
You don't go out to kill anybody. You never go out with the intention and say to yourself, oh, today I'm going to run down a pedestrian. A few beers with the friends. Bang. Seeing the head come through the windscreen again. Vividly, like it's there today, now. And the fact that I am the cause of it, I can't take that back. But it doesn't change the fact I've become a killer.
Just a huge void, and there's nothing to fill it. Nothing at all.
The driver had been drinking and just smashed his car into the back of Michelle's car, and she died of head injuries.
Oh, she was lovely. She was full of energy, full of enthusiasm. Even if I could just hold her hand for 5 minutes, or tell her again how much I love her, or just touch her hair, I would give the world for that.
Push you to the limit. Before you cross that line, stop. Full stop.
Shaking a baby can cause brain damage. Before you cross that line, stop. Full stop. When you have a baby, breathing deeply can help control the pain. Baby can push you to the limit. Before you cross that line, stop. Full stop.
If you know a baby who is suffering from neglect, please, don't neglect to tell us.
Order! Order! The amendment is vital because the quality of water used in the production of Scotch whiskey is of great significance.
What I describe as an obvious injustice is that the value of luncheon vouchers has not increased for many years.
Hear, hear,
hear. I suggest that every dog should wear a disc, which would be not only a form of identification,
but a sign that the license fee had been paid.
Every Sunday, sporting events take place at which the Sunday Observance Act 1780 is openly and flagrantly breached.
Caused by the imposition of VAT on chocolate biscuits. Now, this is a very serious matter for the biscuit eaters of this country.
What quantity of still and carbonated waters were sold in the House of Commons refreshment department in the last year?
What your MP isn't talking about is that 5 million children die in the Third World every year. That's the equivalent of all the under-fives in Britain, France, Italy, Spain and Germany. And they don't talk about why the aid we give to the Third World is worth less than half what it was 7 years ago. It would only take about a dozen letters to make your MP talk about that instead. Or maybe you think what they're talking about at present is more important.
Oi! What's this mess? What's this mess? Now you, clear this up. Clear it up! Do you hear me? I don't want mess when I get home from... Come here!
You!
Adrenaline surges through the body. Heart racing. Blood pumping. Breathless. Exhausted. Gasping for air. An intense burning pain. As the wire rips through skin, cutting deep, tightening, crushing the windpipe, forcing the tongue against the inner cavity of the throat, attempts to cry out go unheard. Trapped, with no means of escape, death is painful. Death is slow.
Basically, he grabbed me and took hold of me. Cancer spreads and it develops fast. My lung was infested with a tumour. I was told that it was malignant. I had to have a major operation and they have taken the lung away. And this is all due to smoking. That white little stick that you put in your mouth. And at 34, you're thinking, I shouldn't be going through this.
If you want to stop smoking, call 0800 169 0169.
Then why has your dad had to have a major operation?
Because he had lung cancer, caused by smoking.
That sounds horrible and scary. But what happened to you when your mum told you that?
I felt worried because I've always associated cancer with death. I thought my dad was going to die.
What are you thinking when you look at that?
He changed. His hair, the way he looks. He looks really weird now. He looks happy there.
He's very brave, isn't he? And you're very brave too. What have you... Okay, that sounds strange, but what have you learnt from all of these things that have been going on?
Don't smoke. Make smoke.
And I walked out with inoperable, incurable lung cancer. Sometimes you can feel it, because it hurts. To get it out. I don't want this horrible thing eating at me. Yeah, I think it's trying to kill me. I mean, my initial reaction when I was told was, okay, well, what are we going to do then? But what I actually thought was, oh God, I'm dying.
If you want to stop smoking, call 0800 169 0169.
I was doing a year ago, 12 months ago, to now. It's immeasurable, the change for me. Devastating. Stroke at 37. That's unbelievable, you know? Part of the blood clot tore off and went through, straight through my head. I can't work now. My balance goes. Dribbles coming out. And then it starts slurring your words. You don't want to tell people you're disabled. I can't carry a bag of shopping now.
I wanted to ask you a little bit more about what feelings you had inside you when you used to see those anti-smoking ads.
When he said shadow, it was a worrying shadow. I thought, that's it. That's lung cancer that's caught up with me. I have forfeited my life for smoking. I've lost the chance of grandchildren, probably. Happy retirement. I've had to give up a job I loved. And there's still so much I want to do.
If you want to stop smoking, call the NHS Smoking Helpline on 0800 169 0169.
The x-ray nurse came out and told me there and then that I had a very large tumour in my right lung. I can only describe it as being some like a floating cauliflower in my chest. This thing's invaded me. I haven't asked it to, although I've smoked so indirectly I have, haven't I? It's the nightmare scenario. And you wonder when you're going to wake up from the nightmare.
If you want to stop smoking, call 0800 169 0169.
I don't think I've had one day that I've felt okay since the day I've had my heart attack. My arteries have become blocked, and then that's restricting blood flow into my heart. It misses a beat, and that missed beat is when it pumps without any blood in it. I can actually feel it when I put my hand on my chest. The major factor in my heart attack, I think, was smoking. I never used to think about consequences or anything. I think the kids have lost 50% of their dad. If they can get an extra day out of me, they will do.
Call the NHS Smoking Helpline on 0800 169 0169.
My name's Janice. I'm 51. The reason why I'm so breathless, the reason why I've got the tube, is for oxygen. This is me for the rest of my life now.
They call it throat cancer. They've come in and removed my voice box. Before they did this, they found out I got lung cancer as well. But the future plans right now are Alexander, my oldest, is coming over here for holiday December 13th. I will be alive for that.
Call 0800 169 0169.
My name is Tony Anthony John. I've had throat cancer. They've come in and removed my voice box. This was caused by smoking. Don't smoke. Do not smoke.
Anthony Hicks also found it difficult to listen when people warned him to stop smoking. Sadly, he died of throat cancer last year. For help giving up smoking and details of your local NHS Stop Smoking service, call 0800 169 0169. Alive.
Fire!
How will you get out alive? How will you get out alive?
Sam! I'm gonna smash your face against that cot if you don't shut your screaming noise!
Come and sit over here.
You're brainless! You're stupid! You're no child of mine!
Mummy, where are you? I don't like being on my own.
Not a word to anyone. This is going to be our little secret.
Sometimes we can't bear to look either, but cruelty to children can be stopped, and with your help, it can be stopped forever. Please support the NSPCC's new Full Stop campaign.
Arrival on the scene, how to treat a stab wound. Now, as the blade enters the body, it tears apart the tissue structure, so you need to be ready for a huge amount of blood. Even a small knife in the leg or the arm is likely to sever a major artery. The victim's going to lose almost half their body's blood within the first half an hour. For every minute after that they go without treatment, the chances of death go up by 10%. So treat wounds to the legs and the arms as seriously as those to the body or the head. You should be familiar with the following common tissues on this stab wound. You can see yellow fatty tissue, brown here is muscle, in the centre, bone. Think about infection. The blade may look clean, but it's usually coated with bacteria. The knife injects this bacteria deep into the body of the victim, causing a virulent infection. Here you can see the effects of gas gangrene on a body that's gone untreated. This was the morning after the victim appeared to be recovering from a stab wound to the leg. Now, the best case scenario here is that he'll lose his leg to amputation. But if the infection spreads to the rest of the body, the most likely outcome is death. A knife in the chest is usually held fast by the bone and the surrounding muscle structure. If the knife is still in the victim, then don't take it out. The wound may be bleeding freely. If the blood is squirting out, then apply pressure till it stops. You can do this by squeezing together the edges of the wound alongside the knife blade. Try to get the victim in a sitting, upright position. This will stop the knife being jolted or knocked out. Now, in many cases, the victim's going to try to remove the knife themselves. Don't allow this to happen. The knife can cause just as much damage on the way out as it did on the way in. So keep the blade in situ, securely, and get the patient to the operating theatre. A stab wound to the abdomen the size of your thumb can expose anything up to 6 meters of intestines. Now, when these become exposed to the air, they may dry out, in which case they'll need to be cut away. An injury to the lower left bowel, like this, for example, could necessitate the surgical removal of a large amount of intestine and the permanent use of a colostomy bag. If the victim is coughing up blood or vomiting, then hold their intestines for them to prevent more intestines coming out.